Hey everybody, hopefully he's having a great week so far, a great day, or a great weekend, whatever time you are watching this video, wherever part of the world you are in, welcome to the I'm Abundance channel, okay? So we're going to be talking about one life hack mindset tip you can incorporate into your life every single day to where you can maximize your life potential, okay? So this is based off of facts and research, so I'm going to be going and sharing this with everybody today, okay? So make sure you stick around all the way to the end of the video. All right, let's go. I want everybody to picture just for 1 second that imagine that you have a sports car, and it's literally any sports car that you can imagine. Maybe it's a Lamborghini, a Ferrari, a McLaren, whatever sports car that you like, Corvette, Mustang. Just imagine that, you know, you took care of that car and you just love that car. You put time and effort into making sure it ran correctly. You put even premium fuel, premium oil, making sure that it's up to speed and doing all the good things for it to run efficient, right? So imagine if you stopped doing those things and you started putting less grade fuel, maybe you didn't even change the oil, you're to it. Just imagine that for a second. So I wanna think about, just imagine your mind as if it's just like that car. So if you were to be putting bad maintenance into your mind, then wouldn't your mind be operating at a much more lower frequency and potential than it could possibly be? So I want everybody to imagine your mind is that Ferrari. Imagine your mind is that McLaren or the Corvette, the Mustang. If you're feeding it and taking care of it, putting good information and good fuel maintenance every day into your mind on the capabilities that it can be. So Maxwell Maltz wrote a book, it's called Psycho-Cybernetics, and he talks about that your mind is a automatic mechanism. So anything that you put into your mind, it will reciprocate back and produce more of. So in other words, thoughts, actions, and then therefore on and on, right? So if we imagine our thoughts, so everybody imagine this for a second, your rational thinking is something that's going to be good for you or it's going to be bad, okay? It's, you get an idea, for instance, you want to go to the store and you rationalize in your head, you think about in your head the correct things and realistic things to do in your head, and then you go and do it, right? So that's rational thinking. So rational thinking can be for you or against you, okay? So if we are putting bad information into our brain, we're putting good information in our brain, then it will put it back in abundance out more for to you. So Maxwell Maltz calls it your success mechanism, and or it could be your failure mechanism. I want you to imagine what are you currently having in your mind right now. Is your mind fixated more going towards a success mechanism, or is it going towards a failure mechanism? Because we may not be able to always control what's around us, but we can definitely control our thoughts and what we are fixed on and what we can concentrate on. Okay, so I really highly recommend that everybody reads this book. It's by Maxwell Maltz. It's called Psycho-Cybernetics. I highly recommend everybody reads this book because it will definitely elevate your thinking. So this man was a surgeon, and he would perform a lot of surgeries on people, and he would create different people. He would essentially perform surgery on them, and then he made a book based off of, is it really surgery that's making these people feel and look better and different? So he actually made a book realizing that it's actually your mindset and what you're fixated on and what you're putting into your mind every single day to actually change your perspective on things. Okay, So if we are actually habitually producing thoughts of failure, if we are habitually producing facts of we are not going to win or we are not going to achieve things in our life, then that will work for you. maybe you're watching this video and you have a goal and you are currently doing something to better yourself. It can literally be anything. It doesn't have to be anything big. It doesn't have to be anything too small. It doesn't have to be anything. Maybe you're going for a certain goal that you're after. Maybe it's your health goals. Maybe it's your business goals, whatever, right? So your mind is already set up to be a goal-striving mechanism. In other words, how Maxwell Maltz also puts it is your goal-striving mechanism. It's just you are in charge of that mind becoming that goal-striving mechanism. Like, who are you hanging out with every single day? Who are you? Who's your circle? What kind of people are you surrounding yourself with? Because this was a huge lesson for me as I was on my journey, is that you are like the people that you associate with. Okay, so a lot of times people are hanging out with people that don't directly correlate with the vision and purpose that they had, and that's perfectly fine. It's just that a lot of people a lot of times end up not changing. So there's nothing wrong with that. So you are the person that you're hanging out with and that you are going the right direction you want to be. So I'm not talking to anybody else. I'm talking to you. The person that's watching this video is you have the potential and the capabilities and you have enough opportunity to do what you want to do. So just choose what you're going to be putting into your mind every single day. Is it going to be bad information or is it going to be positive information that's going to elevate your life every day? Okay, so my name is Daniel and thank you very much for watching the video. It definitely means a lot to me, okay? So if you really enjoyed this video, I highly recommend checking out some of these videos because I post videos like this, growing yourself as a person, your confidence, every single week, okay? And you definitely don't want to miss them. So if you like the video, then definitely go ahead and hit a like button for me, okay? So thank you everybody for watching and we'll see you in the next video.